माननीय मंत्री जी
टल पर रखा गया।
माननीय सदस्य
सर, द मिनिस्टर हैज गिवन ए रिप्लाई व्हिच इज वेरी स्किल्फुल। माय क्वेश्चन वाज वेदर द गवर्नमेंट हैज टेकन एनी स्टेप्स टू इम्प्रूव सिविल एयरक्राफ्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इन इंडिया। नाउ वी हैव टू बाई ऑलमोस्ट 7 लाख करोड़ ऑफ एयरक्राफ्ट फ्रॉम बोइंग, एयरबस, एम्ब्रेयर, बोम्बार्डियर एटसेट्रा। दे आर डोमिनेटिंग द होल मार्केट। नाउ इट वॉज एक्सपेक्टेड दैट वी मेक इन इंडिया वी शैल बी स्टार्टिंग टू मेक सिविलियन एयरक्राफ्ट। मे आई नो फ्रॉम द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर वॉट स्टेप्स इज टेकिंग टू स्टार्ट रियल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ पैसेंजर एयरक्राफ्ट इन इंडिया। वी हैव डन वेल इन द फील्ड ऑफ मिलिट्री एयरक्राफ्ट, बट इन पैसेंजर एयरक्राफ्ट वी आर फार बिहाइंड। विल द यंग एंथुसियास्टिक मिनिस्टर टेक सम स्टेप्स इन दिस रिगार्ड?
So the member is very correct that the civil aviation sector consists of just not only airline operations and airport operations, but it must, the whole ecosystem must develop. And in order for that ecosystem to develop, the industry must go from nascency towards growth phase, which is where we are going today. So not only airlines and airports, but MROs, FTOs, aircraft manufacturing, these are very, very important parts for the growth of the civil aviation sector in any country. There are two methods to look at this. One is a top-down approach, where you build a whole aircraft, or a bottom-up approach, from where you look at building components rising to the level of aircraft. And I'm pleased to report through you, sir, to the House, that India has advanced tremendously over the last 3 or 4 years towards manufacturing full aircraft. At the date today, we have Boeing and Tata in a joint venture called Tata Boeing Airspace Limited, which is today manufacturing the Apache fuselages in India for not only operation within India, but internationally as well. They are being exported. Also, Airbus has tied up with Tata Advanced Systems to put in a joint bid to replace the Avro aircraft of the IAF with Airbus C-295 machines for medium transport. Along with that, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, which is really the linchpin of our manufacturing capability in India, has taken 5 very important steps in the area of aircraft manufacturing. First, 2 civil aviation Dornier 228s have already been manufactured in India and are being provided to Alliance Air. Second, made in India, we are manufacturing today, as you said, Atmanirbhar Bharat, Saugata Rai Saab, we are manufacturing the Indian version of the Dornier 228, which is called the Hindustan 228 in India, and 6 civil aircrafts are under production with our own internal funding of HAL. Third, there is an MOU that HAL has entered into with CSIR and National Aerospace Laboratories to produce the Saras aircraft. The Saras aircraft is a 14-seater turboprop aircraft which will be used for regional transport within India. Fourth, we are also producing a 19-seater light transport aircraft within India for, again, with CSR to give a new impetus to regional transport. And finally, the ALH, the Air Light Helicopter Dhruv, is also being produced by HAL. So we are progressing very rapidly in this area of manufacturing of aircraft, which Saugata Rai Ji rightly pointed out is very important to provide the core impetus for aircraft and airline civil aviation sector in India.
Sir, China has already built up its own aircraft manufacturing capacity. Brazil has nationalized Embraer and they are manufacturing planes. Now, when we are buying small aircraft, IndiGo has ordered for buying ATR 72. They have ordered for buying 50 ATR 72. Now, these smaller aircraft are necessary to have local, for the Udan scheme, to have local taxi services. Now, my question is, what is the, I also know, as the minister rightly mentioned, that Tata Advanced System, Mahindra Airspace, Bharat Funds, they are building capacity to manufacture aircraft. Only Reliance Defense, owned by Anil Ambani, is a non-starter. May I know from the Honorable Minister whether any replacement for ATR-72s is planned by the Ministry, and whether he is setting up any system to regulate the air taxi system for flying short distances of air taxis on the Uran scheme.
Sir, through you, I'd like to place on the table of the House that as far as short distance is concerned, we have two optional aircraft possible to ply those short distances under Uran. And those short distances are in the range of 300 nautical miles and upwards. That is one, the ATR-72. There's another version of that, a smaller version called the ATR-42. But we have not got that in our fleet as of today. But there's also the Bombardier Q-400. So both these aircraft are turboprop aircraft which have a capacity of between 55 to 72 seats, which are being used to ply these routes. Uran has been a very, very successful scheme in terms of viability gap funding to connect previously unconnected or underconnected locations. And under that scheme, not only have we provided connectivity between smaller cities and large metros, but we have also built 63 airports, heliports, and water drones. So our dream of making sure that we grow from the earlier 74 airports prior to 2014 to 138 airports that we are today. So we've almost doubled the number of airports within 7 years, sir. And along with that, we plan to grow to 220 in the next 4 to 5 years. So increasing that infrastructure is our imperative, and we will surely deliver on that. I would like to apprise the Honourable Member. Thank you.
प्रश्नकाल समाप्त. सभा पटल पर रखे जाने वाले पत्र आइटम नंबर टू, श्री वीके सिंह जी.
सभापति महोदय, आपकी अनुमति से मैं संशोधित कार्य सूची के क्रम संख्या दो पर मेरे नाम के सामने उल्लिखित पत्रों को सदन पटल पर रखता हूं.
आइटम नंबर श्री कृष्णपाल जी.
आदरणीय अध्यक्ष महोदय, मैं आपकी अनुमति से आज की संशोधित कार्य सूची की क्रम संख्या तीन पर मेरे नाम के सामने सूचीबद्ध दस्तावेजों को सदन के पटल पर रखता हूं.
आइटम नंबर फोर, श्री भानु प्रताप सिंह वर्मा जी.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, आपकी अनुमति से मैं आज की कार्य सूची में क्रम संख्या चार पर मेरे नाम के आगे उल्लिखित कागजात को सदन के पटल पर रखता हूं.
आइटम नंबर फाइव, श्री रामेश्वर तेली जी.
महोदय, मैं आपकी अनुमति से आज की कार्यसूची के क्रम संख्या पाँच पर मेरे नाम से उल्लेखित दस्तावेज लोकसभा के पटल पर रखता हूं.
आइटम नंबर श्री कौशल किशोर जी.
मानी जी, आपकी अनुमति से मैं आज की संशोधित कार्य सूची में क्रम संख्या छः पर मेरे नाम के समक्ष सूचीबद्ध कागजातों की एक एक प्रत हिंदी व अंग्रेजी में सभा पटल पर रखता हूं.
आइटम नंबर सेवन, श्री विशेषर टूडू जी.
सर, विथ योर काइंड परमिशन आई ले दिस स्टेटमेंट mentioned against my name in today's revised list of business at serial number 7 on the table of the house. Thank you.
Item number 8, Sri Jan Balla ji.
Adhyaksh Mahoday, aapki anumati se main aaj ki sanshodhit karya suchi mein mere naam ke samne karm sankhya 8 mein ulikhit kagjat sadan ke patal par rakhta hun.
Item number 9, Dr. Hina Gavit.
Sir, I rise to present the fifth report, Hindi and English version, of the Committee on Empowerment of Women 2021-22 on the subject Empowerment of Women Through Education, with special reference to Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme, as listed against my name at serial number 9 in today's order paper.
Item number 10, Sri Rajendra Agarwal ji.
Mananiya Adhyaksh ji, aapki anumati se main aaj ki karya suchi mein kramank sankhya 10 par mere naam ke samaksh yatha suchibaddh सरकारी आश्वासन और संबंधी समिति का 52वां व 53वां प्रतिवेदन प्रस्तुत करता हूं.
आइटम नंबर 11, श्री राकेश सिंह जी. श्री कुमार हेब्रम जी.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, आज के आपके अनुमति से मैं आज की जता संशोधित कार्यसूची में मेरे नाम के सम्मुख जता सूचीबद्ध कोयला खान और इस्पात संबंधी स्थायी समिति के 11 की कार्रवाई विवरण हिंदी और इंग्रेजी भाषण सभा पटल पर रखता हूँ।
आइटम नंबर 12 श्री मंजुलता मंडल जी।